This is the Ilisu Dam. A $1.7 billion hydroelectric plant located in Turkey with the capacity of a small nuclear reactor. While the project significantly benefits the local economy, its construction sparked such widespread controversy that it led to international boycotts. Thus, it lost all international funding and even became the target of an armed attack. But in the end, construction was finished successfully, and the dam has been fully operational for 3 years now. Today, we'll uncover why the dam was built in the first place, the reasons behind the controversy, and carefully analyze its impact. The Ilisu Dam is located in southeastern Turkey, close to the Syrian border. It's built on the Tigris River, which is historically one of the most important rivers in the whole world, being the birthplace of one of the most ancient civilizations, Mesopotamia. The dam has transformed more than 100 kilometers of this river and its tributaries, creating a reservoir with a total area equivalent to the entirety of the country of Malta. To hold such an incredible amount of water, the dam needs to be 135 meters tall and almost 2 kilometers wide. This makes it one of the largest in the country and on par with the other mega dams, such as the enormous Ataturk Dam. Why has such a gigantic structure needed in the first place? As part of the local $32 billion Southeastern Anatolia Project, or SAP, its roots date back far into the previous century, even before World War II. Electrical energy was a pressing issue at the time, especially in the country's southeastern region. As a result, the Turkish government scouted the two main rivers, the Euphrates and the Tigris, for suitable locations to build hydroelectric plants. Over time, several locations were chosen and eventually united under the SAP. So far, they've built 22 dams and 19 power plants with a total capacity of 27 gigawatts, enough to power nearly 10 million households. Furthermore, the project also provides irrigation for the whole region, thanks to the stored water, which can be released as required. This enabled an almost threefold increase in local cotton production between 1991 and 2001. Many of these dams had already been built in the 80s and 90s. However, the Ilisu Dam is among the newer ones, with its foundation stone laid in just 2006. Which brings us to the construction process of the dam. While it was expected to be completed in 2016, the process didn't go as planned due to multiple delays during construction. The first one was caused by financial difficulties. Originally, the dam was supposed to be funded with the help of multiple European agencies. However, 2 years into the construction, this funding was cut off. But why? We've already mentioned the historical importance of the Tigris River. One example of this importance can be found only 60 kilometers upstream of the dam. In this region lies the ancient town Hasankeyf, numerous archaeological sites dating back more than 10,000 years. The problem was that as the dam's reservoir would fill up, significant portions of the town would be submerged. Everything from ornate mosques, Islamic tombs, to cave churches would end up underwater. But the problem was much bigger, as Hasankeyf wasn't supposed to be the only submerged town. In addition, nearly 200 entire villages were located in the affected area, from which nearly 80,000 people would be forced to relocate. These facts, along with other environmental concerns, stirred up massive international controversy. Environmental and human rights organizations pressured the European agencies to cut off the funding of the dam. So the Turkish government had to finance the whole project solely through internal investors. Eventually, the government received loan approval from a local bank, and the construction resumed in 2010. The second major delay occurred in 2014, when the construction site was the target of an armed attack by a militant political organization called the Kurdistan Workers' Party, or PKK. Kurds are an ethnic minority in Turkey, accounting for roughly 20% of the total population. Some of them have long dreamed of an independent Kurdish state, and the PKK is one of the more prominent organizations working to achieve that goal. As a result, it's been involved in a long-standing conflict with the Turkish government, which is frequently turned violent. Because the organization is located in southeast Anatolia, the entire SAP project has a direct impact on them. The PKK has claimed that the project was built solely for security purposes and to restrict their military movement. In an effort to stop the construction process, they launched numerous attacks against various dams, including the Ilisu. Those attacks resulted in a temporary suspension of the construction, which took multiple months. Without further problems, the dam was finally completed in 2018, and the reservoir was ready for impoundment. However, Iraq, a downstream country of the Tigris, was experiencing severe water shortages at the time. Thus, the reservoir's filling had to be postponed for yet another year. Finally, in 2020, the project was finished, and the dam's power plant began generating electricity. Equipped with 6 massive turbines, it converts the immense pressure generated by the water into electrical power. Thanks to that, it's able to generate approximately 3.8 gigawatts annually, which is enough to power around 1.3 million households in the area. And this brings us to the impact of the Ilisu Dam. Let's first look at the positive side and analyze the benefits it provides. As we've already mentioned, the electrical contribution to the national grid is pretty substantial, particularly given that it's also clean energy, reducing the country's reliance on fossil fuels. But it also brings other notable economic benefits to the region, one being in the form of controlled water release, which enables better irrigation of local arid land, transforming them into fertile agricultural zones. This helps the local economy by increasing crop production. There are also thousands of job opportunities created by the dam, whether in the power plant or agricultural sectors. But now, let's dive into the dam's controversies and negative effects. The obvious one is the enormous construction cost of $1.7 billion, which skyrocketed due to the loss of international funding. And then there's Hasankeyf. In response to the construction plans, massive efforts were made to uncover and document as much information about the archaeological sites as possible before it was too late. Some of the historical structures were even carefully dismantled and relocated to higher ground. This new historical park, now called New Hasankeyf, is located on the reservoir's shore. Still, major parts of the original town were submerged, resulting in significant cultural loss. Aside from the financial and cultural cost, the dam had a substantial human and environmental impact as well. The reservoir has displaced tens of thousands of people from their homes, forcing them to either move higher into the mountains or somewhere else entirely. There are also concerns that the dam is putting the regional biodiversity at risk by affecting many already endangered local species, such as the Eurasian otter, the marbled duck, and the red-wattled lapwing. However, the local region isn't the only area affected in a negative way. Another factor to consider is the dam's impact on downstream countries, particularly Syria and Iraq. Both have expressed concerns about the dam's potential to reduce the flow of the Tigris River, which is a vital source of water for countless communities and agriculture in both countries. So, considering the turbulent story of the dam, to what extent has the project really been successful? On the one hand, the economic impact of its green power generation, regional irrigation, and thousands of job opportunities is definitely a good thing. On the other hand, the cost of displacing tens of thousands of people, as well as the submergence archaeological sites, is enormous. Weighing these factors against one another is a difficult task, which is why the dam remains a controversial subject to this day. It's often criticized for the authority's stubborn attitude during the development, pushing the project forward despite its tremendous cost. Many argue that there were alternative solutions to the power generation problems, which could potentially have avoided the majority of the negative effects. Solar and wind power plants, for example, could take advantage of Turkey's abundant sunlight, wide open steppes, and windy plains. On the flip side, there are even some locals supporting the project, who desire the region to develop like the rest of the world. They consider the criticism from developed countries hypocritical, given that these countries have often built similar structures in the past. But what do you think? Do the benefits of the dam outweigh its negative impact, or would it be better if the dam wasn't built after all? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. If you want to see more about similar projects, you should watch our video about Africa's $80 billion megadam. Thank you for watching, and as always, we'll see you in the next video.